Hi, let's discuss simplification of context-free grammar, the process of detection and elimination of useless symbol, unit production and null production is called simplification of CFG or context-free grammar. Let's first do useless symbol. The variable or non-terminal which not involve in derivation of any string called useless symbol. Let's see some example. First example. Here one language is given S derive A, S or A derive B, B derive A. You can see from S you cannot reach to B. Okay, from S you can derive A, S or A. There is no B. That's why we will delete this. This is a useless symbol. You cannot reach to B. Just remove that production. Then S tends to A, S or A tends to B. So after removal of useless symbol, we got this grammar. B was a useless symbol, we just remove B. Next example, from S you can derive a S or A or BB. Then from A you can derive B. Which variable are useful which can generate some string? From A we can generate some string, but from B you cannot generate any string. For B no production is given, so we'll delete this. Here this B was not reachable from S. Here this B is not deriving any string. If any variable is not deriving any string, then that is a useless symbol. We'll just delete B. After removal of useless symbol, you'll get this grammar. S tends to A, S or A tends to B. Let's see another example. You can see there are four variables. One is S, another is A, another is B, another is C. From S, A, B there is some production, but from C there is no production. So C is a useless symbol as it is not deriving any string. So wherever C is present, that will delete. We'll delete this, we'll delete this. After removal of C, now this will be the grammar. S tends to A tends to AB or BA or A, B tends to BA or B. C was the useless symbol, so just remove C. The variable that cannot reach from the start symbol of grammar is useless symbol. Here we cannot reach to B, so that is a useless symbol. Second, the variable which is reachable from the start symbol but doesn't derive any terminal is useless symbol. So like here, this B is reachable from the start symbol but it is not deriving anything. Here this C is reachable from the start symbol but it is not deriving anything. So two things we need to take care. One is it should be reachable from start symbol. Second, it should be derive some string. The grammar which is free from useless symbol is called reduced context free grammar. Let's see another example. A grammar is given. Now you can mark from B and C you cannot derive any terminal. From B you are deriving BC, from C you are deriving CAB or CA. You are not deriving any terminal, so that's why it will not terminate. We will delete B production and C production. So after deleting B production and C production, wherever B and C is present, we'll just delete that. So we'll delete this BC, we'll delete this, we'll delete this AB. Now reduced context-free grammar will be S tends to AB, A tends to AA, or B. Why we delete this? We delete this as it is not generating any terminal. What is string? String is a collection of terminal. If one variable is not generating any terminal, then that is useless. So we remove B and C production, and wherever B, C was present, we just remove that. Unit production, the production of the form A tends to B, where A, B both belongs to variable is called unit production. So we need to remove the unit production and replace the equal derivation. Let's see some example. First example, S tends to A tends to BA or B or B. This is a variable B, this is a terminal B. Then B derive A. So what is unit production here? A tends to B, that is the unit production. Here B is present, that we need to remove. But grammar should not be changed. So what we'll do, we'll just remove B. And whatever the B production that we'll write here, we'll write A here and we'll remove this as it is not necessary. So after removal of unit production, S tends to AA, then A will derive BA or A or B. A due to this B. Next example, x tends to x a y, x tends to y or b, y tends to x or a. So what are the unit production here? X tends to y, this is one unit production, then y tends to x, this is another unit production. Suppose you want to remove this one, then y tends to a or x, so that thing you can write here. Now x can derive b or a. Here also you need to remove y. In place of y, you can write x. So after removal, it will be s tends to x a x, then x tends to a b. Suppose you want to remove this, x tends to y, then you will write s tends to y a y. In place of x, you will just write y, then y tends to a or b. Next example, a tends to b a x, b tends to x, a b or b, x tends to y tends to z or c, z tends to d. Now what are unit production? B derive x, that is one unit production, then x derive y, that is another unit production, y derive z, this is another unit production. There are three unit production. Let me first remove y tends to z. So I'll remove this z. What z is deriving? Z is deriving d. So I'll just write d here. Then y derive c or d. Let me next remove x tends to y. When I am removing y, in place of y, I can write c or d. Now x derive c or d. Now I need to remove this unit production. So when you are removing x, you can write c or d. And you can remove this production. And here there is also x, and we are removing x production. So in place of x, you can write c or b a d. B a c for c, then b a d. So after removal of unit production from a, you can derive b a c or b a d. Then from b, you can derive c or d or a b or b. A b b was there, and c or d, that is in place of x. So just remove this production, this production, this production, then we remove this x, we remove this x. After removal of unit production, we are just finding this grammar. Next, null production. The production of the form a derive epsilon, where a is a variable, is called null production. We need to remove the null production and replace with equal derivation. Let's see some example. Here from x we are deriving epsilon, from y we are deriving epsilon. So what you can do here, c, y is given. In place of y, if you put epsilon, you will get simply c. Just remove the epsilon and write your c. And here in place of x, if you put epsilon, you will get simply b. So just write b. Then here x a y is given, x a y. In place of x, if you put epsilon, you will get a y. In place of y, if you put epsilon, you will get x a. If in place of x and y both you put epsilon, then you will get simply a. So write here a y, then x a or a. Now null production is removed. Let's try the grammar again. So from a you can derive x a y. Then x a when y is epsilon, a y when x is epsilon, then a. Then from x you can derive b x or b. From y you can derive c y or c. Next example, a tends to b c, b tends to a b or epsilon, c tends to b c or epsilon. So in place of c, when you substitute epsilon, you will get simply b. In place of b, when you substitute epsilon, you will get simply a. And here, in place of b, when you substitute epsilon, you will get c. In place of c, when you substitute epsilon, you will get b. And in place of both b and c, when you substitute epsilon, you will get epsilon. Just remember one thing, if one language is generating epsilon, then you cannot remove epsilon. Here, the language is generating epsilon, that's why epsilon cannot remove from this production. From b and c you can remove, but from a you cannot remove. So after removal of null production, the grammar will be like this. From a you can derive b or c or epsilon. Then from b you can derive a b or a. Then from C you can derive BC or B. Here epsilon will be there as the language is generating epsilon. If the language is generating epsilon, then we cannot remove it. Next, order of simplification process. First, remove the null production or epsilon production. You can mark after removal of null production, you are getting here unit production. So first remove the null production, then remove this unit production. So first step, remove null production. Second step, remove unit production. Third, eliminate useless symbol. So you have to simplify a grammar in this process. What is null production? If a epsilon transition is there, you can remove that epsilon transition. Then what is unit production? If one variable tends to another variable, you can replace with equal derivation. Then useless symbol, if a variable is not reachable from the start symbol, and if a variable is not deriving any string, that is useless symbol. So you can remove in this sequence. If any doubt, just ask me in comment. Thank you.